If you've seen my channel before, then you may have stumbled across my previous videos all about the Hildebrand Glow in-home display for your smart meter and how to connect it to Home Assistant. Well, I've had a bit of feedback on those videos and decided I could do a better job, so here is the ultimate definitive guide to getting the Glow CAD and display working locally with Home Assistant. I'll start with a very quick overview of the Glow CAD before I jump into the configuration details. The Glow CAD is a special type of in-home display for your smart meter, and it has a number of advantages over the free display that you might have been given when the meter was installed. The Glow display can be used alongside your free display if you want, but the Glow display will also connect to your Wi-Fi network and relay live power and energy data to Glow's servers. You can use their Bright app to view that if you like, and they also provide a cloud-based API that you can use to retrieve that data. But, and this is my opinion only, the best feature of the Glow display is that you can connect to it locally over your own home network to get that same data, and that means that you can integrate it nicely into your home automation solution of choice without using the internet. I'll put a link down in the description to where you can buy these displays from, but you must get them direct from Hildebrand's Glow Market site. This is because they have to be paired to your smart meter before they're sent out. At the time of recording this video, they only have the wireless display version available, but there is a version without a display coming soon too. Onto the configuration then. Before you start trying to get Home Assistant working with the display, make sure that you have it configured to connect to your Wi-Fi network and that it's reporting live data back to their Bright app. If that part isn't already working, then the rest of this process probably won't work either. Now, onto Home Assistant, and I'll be starting with an almost brand new clean installation of it, so as I can show you every step in the process. We will need some way to edit the Home Assistant configuration files. If you know how to do that already, then skip ahead. Otherwise, I suggest you install the File Editor add-on. From the Home Assistant dashboard, navigate down to Settings, Add-ons, click on this Add-on Store button, and we'll just search for File Editor. You can see it appears in the list. We'll click on that, click on Install. It'll take a little while, so I'll cut the video here and jump back when it's installed. There we go. We just click on Start, and then once it's running, there we go. I suggest you tick this little box here to show in sidebar, so as it appears nice and conveniently in this menu over on the left. Now we need to configure an MQTT broker, which is the component that the Glow display will talk directly to. We'll start by creating a user just for use by MQTT. We'll need to enable advanced mode first by clicking on our profile name down here at the bottom in the menu, and then scrolling down to the advanced mode toggle and turning it on. Then we can head over to the settings tab, click on people, click on the users tab up at the top, and we'll go down and add a user. For the display name, we're going to use MQTT user, and we're going to use exactly the same for the username as well. And then you need to type in a nice and secure password twice, but don't forget, it can't be too difficult to type because you have to type it in a bit, so remember that. And then make sure that you toggle the option to can only log in from the local network and administrator, and then click on create. Now to install the Mosquito add-on, which is the MQTT broker itself. We go down to Settings, Add-ons, Add-on Store, and we're going to search for Mosquito Broker. Click on that, click on Install. This will take a good couple of minutes, so I'll cut back once it's ready. Okay, there shouldn't be any further configuration needed, so you should just be able to go ahead and click on Start. Now it's running, we need to enable the MQTT integration in Home Assistant. We go down to Settings, over to Devices and Services, and it should auto-discover it here. So we just click on Configure, click on Submit, Finish, and we're done. Now we're going to configure your display to talk to Home Assistant using MQTT. We first need to find out Home Assistant's IP address. Now, I know in my case, I've actually got the IP address up here, but sometimes you might be using a host name, so you might not be aware of what that is. To find it out, go down to Settings, System, Network. Now, if your Home Assistant server is connected wirelessly, you want to look on this WLAN 0 section. If you're connected using a network cable, then ETH0 is the one to use. I'm wireless at the moment, so I'm going to click on that. Then tap on these three dots here and click on IP information. You should see the IP address displayed here in the IP address section. We're after just this part here that's before the /24. So in my case, I need to make a note of 192.168.1.13. Armed with that IP address, we're going to open up the displays menu, choose metering, MQTT, and we're going to enter the IP address, which in my case was 192.168.1.13. Okay, I'm going to leave the port as 1883. The topic is GLO in lowercase. I'm actually going to change this now to lowercase MQTT user, which is what we set up earlier. And then the password is my super secret test one. And okay, and save. Now we need to get the unique MAC address of our display. There are a couple of ways to do this. You can navigate through the display to Wi-Fi, and you'll see this section here that says MAC. Look for the characters after the word MAC and write them down all in capitals, ignore the colons, and you should end up with a 12 character string. Alternatively, turn the display over, pull out the power, slide off the back cover, and you should see this section here that says Wi-Fi. That is also the MAC address that you need. So again, just write down all of the characters in uppercase without the colons and save that for later. Now for the fun part. Down in the description for this video will be a link to an article on my website. If you take a look at that article, there will be some configuration for you to copy and paste. Copy that to your clipboard, then open the file editor add-on. Make sure you are editing the file called configuration.yaml by selecting the Browse File System button, making sure you're in the config directory and clicking on configuration.yaml. I'm already in that file here. Click at the bottom of it, make a little bit of space and paste in your configuration. Now, if you look at the configuration, you'll see your device ID appears in every single one of them. You need to replace your device ID with those 12 characters that you got from the MAC address of your display. I think there are 9 places where you need to replace that. Once you've finished, click on Save, and then you need to restart Home Assistant by going to Developer Tools, check the configuration to make sure that there are no errors, and then clicking on Restart. Once it's rebooting, you should really check it's all working, and you can do that by going down to Settings, Devices and Services, click on Entities and filter by Smart Meter. If you click on one of the entities, so this one Energy Export, and go to Info, you can see some data is being populated, so it's all working. Now you have all of that data, you'll probably want to do something with it. Built into Home Assistant is an energy dashboard that you can use to track your energy usage from your smart meter. It's quite easy to set up, and I'll show you how to do that now. We'll start by creating some utility meters. We can create one for electricity imported, one for gas if you have a gas meter, and one for electricity exported if you have solar. Navigate to Settings, Devices and Services, Helpers up at the top, and create helper there. And we go all the way down to the bottom and choose utility meter. Now the name I'm going to use here is Smart Meter Electricity Energy Import Daily. And the input sensor is going to be Smart Meter Electricity Energy Import. The meter reset cycle I'm going to set to daily, and click on submit because that's all the configuration we need. I'm going to do exactly the same for the gas meter and the export meter as well, but I'll speed that up so you don't have to watch it all. Once you've set up these entities, you're going to want to give it a good hour, I reckon, because these sensors all need to start populating with data before we can configure them in the energy dashboard. Once you've left it for a little while, hopefully, if you go and check your meters, you should have some data populating in them. So I'll just double check here. Yep, I've got values in. So now we can go ahead and configure the energy dashboard. We go to energy on the left-hand side, and we want to add a grid consumption, and this will be our daily import sensor, and we click on save. Now we want to add a return to grid, and this will be our daily export sensor. Click on save. We'll then go next. I haven't got any solar panels in this example, or battery in this example. I have got gas, but that's not pulled in any data yet. That needs a little bit longer, and I can't be bothered to wait just for this video. But if you did want to add your gas sensor here, it would appear in this list. I'm going to go cancel and next, and then show me my energy dashboard. And there you go, you get a nice graphical breakdown of your energy for the day. The energy dashboard is great to show you all of your historical energy data, but what if you want to view live power being used by your home right now? Well, you can easily create a gauge card on your dashboard for the power import entity if you want, but if you prefer something a little fancier, then you should check out the various power flow cards that are available. I have another video already on configuring power flow cards, so you should check that out if you're interested. They certainly look great on your dashboard. Anyway, I hope you found this useful, and if you did, then please give the video a like, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.